Hello everyone, welcome to maths video class 6 chapter 25 and we are on transversal lines, studying different types of angles. Okay, now in previous video we have seen transversal cut, we have seen different types of angles formed when a transversal cuts to non-parallel line. Now we have different properties when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal. Now you know the types of angles. Types of angles means exterior angle pair, interior angle, exterior alternate angle, interior alternate angle, corresponding angle, this angle and this angle. Okay. So now these angles should be in your mind so that we can solve, we can understand this better. Okay. So when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, condition is these two lines should be parallel and it should be cut by a transversal. Then what happens? Okay. So now then exterior alternate angles are equal. Now exterior alternate angles, you can see 1, 7, 2 and 8. So we say that angle 1 is equal to angle 7. Exterior alternate angles are equal when two parallel lines are cut by one transversal. So angle exterior alternate angles are equal. So angle 2 is equal to angle 8 and angle 1 is equal to angle 7. Okay. Interior alternate angles are also equal. Interior alternate angle 3 is equal to angle 5 and angle 4 equals to angle 6. This is the second property. Third is corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. These are corresponding angles. Angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Angle 2 is equal to angle 6. Angle 3 is equal to angle 7. Angle 4 is equal to angle 8. Now in this case, if you don't remember only which are corresponding angles, which are exterior alternate angles, then there is no point. So you have to remember which are corresponding angles, which are interior, exterior alternate angles and so on. Okay, that should not be forgotten. Then co-interior angles are supplementary. This is not equal. This is supplementary something. Co-interior angles are supplementary. Co-interior angles were 3 and 6, if you remember from the last video. So, in co-interior angles, 3 and 6, 4 and 5. So, angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree. Supplementary means 180. So, angle 3 plus angle 6 is equals to 180 degree. Angle 4 plus angle 5 equals to 180 degree. Reason is, when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, co-interior, conjoint or allied angles are supplementary, that is 180 degree. Last is exterior allied angles are supplementary. Now exterior allied angles, angle 2 and angle 7 equals to 180 degree, angle 1 plus angle 8 equals to 180 degree, means exterior allied angle, these two are exterior allied angles, sum of them is 180 degree, means they are supplementary, means when you add you will get 180 degree. So if you remember this, first what is important, you should know that angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angle, these two are co-interior angle, these two are alternate exterior angle, these two are alternate interior angle, like this you should remember, then you will remember these properties. Okay. So, we have seen what are different types of angles and now we will see the exercise. Exercise 25B. Identify the pair of angles in each of the figures given below. Adjacent angles. Now, angles are given. Different angles are given. Adjacent angles, vertically opposite angles, interior alternate angles, corresponding angles or exterior alternate angles. So, now this is the figure. And this figure 2 and angle 4. 2 and angle 2 and angle 4. Which type of angles these are? One line is common in this. In these two angles, this arm is common. So we say that this is adjacent angle. Angle 2 and angle 4 are adjacent angle. Okay. Then angle 1 and angle 8. Angle 1 and angle 8. So these two are exterior alternate angle. Exterior angle 1 and angle 8 are exterior alternate angle. 4 and 5, angle 4 and 5, these are interior alternate angles. Angle 1 and angle 5, angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. Angle 3 and angle 5, angle 3 and angle 5, co-interior angles, conjoint angles or allied angles. Understood? So this way you have to write angle 2 and angle 4 adjacent angles. This way you have to write. Okay. So I hope you will solve it. Now 2 and 7 if you'll see, this is the transversal. So you can just hold your book this way and then this is the transversal cutting these two lines. So you can hold your book this way and then you can write the answer. Okay. Now we'll see third ones. B is homework, children. So you have to send only B part to me. Angle 1 and angle 10. Angle 1 and angle 10. Abhi you will say, oh my god, such a big confusion. No confusion. Just hold your book in such a way that angle 1 and angle 10 means these two lines are cut by this transversal. So this is the transversal in this and this. So angle 1 and angle 10 are corresponding angles. Forget this. Forget this line is transversal for this. So forget this part. Completely forget this part. And remember, just consider this. Okay, these two parts. So angle 1 and angle 2, if you can see in the figure, these are corresponding angles. See, okay. See, angle 1 and angle 10. Now you can see these two lines are cut by this. So angle 1 and angle 10 are corresponding angles. Next is, if you can see here, 6 and 12. 6 and 12. So now I have to consider this. Now these two lines are cut by this. So 6 and 12 exterior alternate angles. 6 and 12. Next is angle 8 and angle 10. Angle 8 and angle 10 interior alternate angle. Angle 4 and angle 11. Now angle 4 means this way. Angle 4 and angle 11. You can see interior alternate angle. Then angle 2 and angle 8. Angle 2 and angle 8. Okay. Now we'll hide this. Angle 2 and angle 8 exterior alternate angle. These are alternate and exterior angle. And last one, 5 and 7. So where is 5? Here is 5 and here is 7. So not, okay, forget this also. 5 and 7, very easy, vertically opposite angles. Okay, so this way you have to solve these questions. So this B is homework, first, and C, I have done it. Okay, so each figure given below shows a pair of parallel lines cut by transversal. For each case, find A and B giving reasons. Okay, you can see these two parallel lines. These two arrows shows that these two are parallel. So find A and B giving reasons. So what is A here? These two are. Okay. So you can see here. Find A and B. So A plus 140 is equal to 180 degrees. So A is equal to 180 minus 140. So A will be 40. And if A is 40, B should be 40. Alternate interior angles. Okay. So that we'll see in the next video. But you can find, you can use different. Now A plus B, this plus this equals to 180 degree. Why? This is, these two are adjacent angle. When we add two adjacent angle, we get 180 degree. So with that we can find out value of A. Once we get A, we'll get B also. A is equal to B, alternate interior angles or interior alternate angles. Okay, so A plus A equals to B. So whatever comes, A will come 40. So this will be 40. This will do in the next, I'll explain in the next video. Up to that, keep studying and keep getting good marks. Thank you so much.